Oh shit, Big Bird has taken a dump on my car. That's better.
Hello, welcome by Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart and today I'm gonna make a vlog. And I know that you don't like my personal vlogs. So, in today's vlog, I go to a computer expo in Schagen. So, let's go.
Arrgh, won't come off.
Yes, rain, that will clean my window.
Almost there. Ah, Retro Gaming Day.
I arrived in Schagen on the Retro Gaming Expo. And Bart van den Akker is also on this expo. And he is busy with making a home computer museum in his town in Helmond, in the south of the Netherlands. So I gonna meet up and see the show. And I got a little present for him. And that's in this red bag. And I don't gonna show you yet. So keep watching and you will find out what's inside of here. And it comes out of a dumpster.
Oh god.
Oh my god.
My name is Bart and I'm the proud owner of a home computer museum in the Netherlands. Yeah, that's me.
And I have a present for you.
Oh, a present.
And it comes out of a dumpster.
It smells good. It smells like old electronics. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. I think it's some MSX. Yeah. I'm a happy camper now.
Yeah, it's the good one.
Yeah, I love it. It's I actually have one, but that's fine. Now I have two. That's even better. And an original game. I love it.
Yeah, I think that the guys at the dumpster cut it up.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they did. It's awesome. Thank you very much, man.
You're welcome.
I love it. I love it. Give you free access to the computer museum now.
Yay! For life?
Well, if you die next year, then yeah. It's a Tandy TRS-80 from 1977 in its original state. As it is right here, would have probably sold for over $5,000 if in this state. And this one's actually from the USA, imported in 1977. And I bought it from the first owner and it was entirely broken when I bought it, and it took 2 months to restore it in this state as it is now, fully booting.
My name is Anne Bras, also known as the PC King, and this is what seems to be a Macintosh AD, I think. Well, it says it here, so it must be true. And I have no clue. I see this screen and I think I have to build like a pinball machine, so I have no idea what I'm doing. The flippers are important. Can I just put them there
so
I block this hole off?
Yeah.
Put multiple flippers there. So like another one like here, so just trying to make an awesome flipper game. Make it a bit more like this then, maybe. All right.
We need a spring.
Is this the spring?
Yes.
It looks like a spring, right? And then do we need a ball? Will this work? Or do I need a little wall to?
Let's try it out.
Play one. All right, there we are. Yeah, the ball is bouncing.
Shift maybe?
This is one flipper. I found a flipper. Now the other one. I'm already very glad that this works. there's the other one. All right, we're getting somewhere. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. All the other buttons possible. Please shoot that thing.
If we put the ball here, it will drop down.
Oh yeah, of course. There we go. I won some free points there, so here we go. Play one, there we go. Oh yes, look at them go. Oh wait, this. There we go. Oh, I'm so proud of this creation of myself. Yeah. This monstrosity. Oh, really, there, so it's like you just get it in there, like in infinite points. There we go. There we go. Yes, I'm really good at this game.
You're cheating.
This is not cheating. This is my own level. I can do whatever I want with it. I'm the creator. And now let's try to die here.
But you have 5 balls.
No, sorry. I can't die.
I think
it's stuck.
Your level has a flaw.
That's the difficulty. It's not a flaw. It's a difficulty. I mean, people know that your ball could get stuck there. If they see this level, they know that. This is an important lesson for them. Life isn't fair. Thank you for watching and enjoying my creation.
Racing game with a Citroën C5. What the f-
This is an Intel MCS 80 or 85. Comes from 1976, and you could buy this as a kit. People should build this together, and learn how a computer works. And I don't know if this one works. This one is completely built as it should be, and it has all documentation. And people at schools were learning from this.
So it's a learning kit.
It's a learning kit, yeah, absolutely.
And what CPU does it use?
It's an Intel 8085.
Okay.
So it's before the 8088, and it's a weird CPU, never came out in a actual PC, but it's fun thing to have.
And I see a keyboard and maybe a simple display.
Yeah. That's it.
That's it.
And a CPU and a controller for the display. That's basically what it is.
And what does it run? Does it have any software
or an
interface? Or
no, there are books. You probably have the books here. You can actually program the CPU yourself. And there's this whole part. You can make your own connections on it. And technically, you could write your own video driver and put it in there, but yeah, probably nobody ever did that.
So this will be on display in your museum.
Absolutely, this will be in the first room where to show this is how it all started. This is basically the computer, one of the computers that made the computers as we have today. So the fact that you're watching YouTube right now. It's because of one of these. I'll show you a laptop.
Come
over. That's a laptop. You could break your legs with it, but...
This is a laptop. Okay.
Yeah. It's actually the first luggable computer. It only weighs 10 kilos and it has a beautiful 5-inch display. My iPhone is bigger than this display.
And what does it run?
CPM. It can only run CPM. And it came, when people bought this, it came with a lot of software, like word processor and I wouldn't say Excel, but that didn't exist back then, but spreadsheet program. And so the software alone was worth $1,500. And to make the price like it is, like it sold for $1,800 approximately. And Osborne gave out stock to software developers so they can give it the software for cheaper with this computer. And this computer from 1981. And one thing that Osborne completely f***ed up was they introduced the new version of an Osborne computer in 1982. But it didn't exist. And everybody decided, okay, let's wait until the new computer comes out. But there was no new computer yet. And sales from this computer completely shut off. And nobody would buy this computer anymore. So in 1983, Osborne went bankrupt.
Whoops.
Yeah,
wrong
whoops.
Decision.
Whoop, wrong. Still called the Osborne effect, by the way, in America.
Yeah. Now the biggest question. Does it run Crysis?
It won't, no.
No?
No, no. Oh. Maybe the text-only version.
Yeah. So, don't leave that in the comments. It doesn't run Crysis.
Portable PCs.
Ja, echt wel.
How much does your portable PC weigh?
Think about 20 kilo.
And your?
Only 11.
So 11?
Only 11, so advanced technology.
Yeah.
But it's also much smaller.
It's also a little bit older.
They're about the same age. Yeah. 1983,
yeah. 1984. So what expo was this? Because you invited me, but...
I didn't invite you.
Yes, you did.
Okay. It's my fault he's here. Sorry. Yeah. Sorry, guys.
So what's the name of the expo?
Good question. I don't know. Game retro event? Game
retro game? Event thingy.
Thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a thing.
Yeah, it's a thing here. Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
I will be doing a video with this guy here soon.
Yes.
Because he is going to start a computer museum. So we're gonna make a video where I'm gonna interview him and he's gonna show us some of the collection and his...
And more!
Where he is going to do it, because he just found a building for it.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah, that's new. That's a premiere. It's new. Last Friday I actually heard I have a building and I'm opening next year in March. Definitely. No way back. In Helmond. Come and visit.
That video will be made later this year.
Yeah.
So, thanks for watching. Please like and share this video. Subscribe and leave a comment. See you next time. And also, join Retro Machines on Facebook. And you can support me on Patreon. And do you have something to say to my viewers?
To your viewers?
Yes.
Keep viewing. And if I'm opening a Kickstarter, please go and... check it out and see if you can sponsor me with opening an actual museum, because it will be fun, it will be amazing, it will be awesome. Just come over to the Netherlands and be there.
Yeah, we will share the Kickstarter in Retro Machines.
Awesome.